Chapter 24, Abhanga. One of the most revered names in a Maharashtrian household is that of Sant Tukaram. Revered, greatly respected and admired. He was a devotee of Lord Vitthala and a proponent and ideal of the Varkari tradition. Devotee, a follower of a particular religion or god. Proponent, a person who proposes a theory or new path. Ideal, a person regarded as perfect. He taught the people that service to humanity is service to God. He gave the message of equality, selflessness, and love of all living things. For hundreds of years, his verses have influenced the people of Maharashtra. He was a great poet, especially known for the simple but noble form of devotional verse, Abhanga. Mahatma Gandhi too was influenced by his writings. He called him a true Vaishnava. He translated some of Abhangas written by Sant Tukaram when he was in Yerawada Central Jail between 15th October 1930 and 28th October 1930. Here are five of them. Zeka Ranzale Ganzale, Tyansi Mhane Jo Apule, Tochi Sadhu Olkhava, Dev Tethechi Zanava, Mrudu Sabahya Navanita, Taise Sajjanaanse Chitta, Jyasi Apangita Nahi, Tyasi Dhari Jo Hrudayi, Daya Karane Je Putrasi, Tochi Dasa Ani Dasi, Tuka Mhane Sangu Kiti, Tochi Bhagavantachi Murti. Know him to be a true man who takes to his bosom those who are in distress. Bosom, the front of a person's chest, especially when thought of as the center of human feelings. Distress, great sorrow, pain or trouble. Know that God resides in the heart of such a one. Reside, be situated. His heart is saturated with gentleness through and through. Saturated, filled completely so that no more can be added. Through and through, completely. He receives as his only those who are forsaken. Forsaken, abandoned or neglected. He bestows on his manservants and maidservants the same affection he shows to his children. Bestow, to give something as an honor or present. Tukaram says, what need is there to describe him further? He is the very incarnation of divinity. The incarnation of one who embodies in human form an abstract quality or a deity. Jethe jato tethe tu majha sangati, chalavisi hati dharuniya, चालो वाटे आम्ही तुझाची आधार, चालविसी भार सवे माझा. बोलो जाता बरळ करिसी ते नीट, नेली लाज धीट केलो देवा. अवघे जन मज झाले लोकपाळ, सोयरे सकळ प्राण सखे. तुका म्हणे आता खेळतो कौतुके, झाले तुझे सुख अंतरबाही. Wherever I go, thou art my companion. Thou, Old English for you. Art, Old English for R. Having taken me by the hand, thou movest me. I go alone depending solely on thee. Solely, only and not involving anyone or anything else. Thee, Old English for you. Thou bearest too many burdens. Bearest, Old English for bear. If I am likely to say anything foolish, thou makest it right. Makest, Old English for makes or make. Thou hast removed my bashfulness and madest me self-confident, O Lord. Hast, Old English for has or have. Bashfulness, reluctance to draw attention to oneself. Madest, Old English for made. All the people have become my guards, relatives and bosom friends. Tuka says, I now conduct myself without any care. I have attained divine peace within and without. Attained, reached or succeeded in getting something. 22-10-1930. पुण्य पर उपकार पाप ते पर पीड़ा आणिक नाही जोड़ा दुजा यासी सत्य तोची धर्म असत्य ते कर्म आणिक हे वर्म नाही दुजे गति तेची मुखी नामाचे स्मरण अधोगति जाण विनमुखता संताचा संग तोची स्वर्गवास नर्क तो उदास अनर्गळा तुका म्हणे उघडे आहे हितघात जयाचे उचित करा तैसे मेरिट कन्सिस्ट इन डूइंग गुड टू अदर्स सिन इन डूइंग हार्म टू अदर्स देर इज नो अदर पेयर कंपेरेबल टू दिस मेरिट द क्वालिटी ऑफ बीइंग गुड एंड डिजर्विंग प्रेज ट्रूथ इज द ओनली रिलीजन ऑफ फ्रीडम अनट्रूथ इज बॉन्डेज देर इज नो सीक्रेट लाइक दिस Bondage, the state of being a slave. God's name on one's lips is itself salvation. Disregard of the name, known to be perdition. Salvation, saving the soul from sin and its consequences. Disregard, lack of consideration or respect for something. Perdition, a state of punishment which goes on forever. Companionship of the good is the only heaven. Studious indifference is hell. Studious, done deliberately or with a purpose in mind. Tuka says, it is thus clear what is good and what is injurious. Let people choose what they will. 15-10-1930 Nahi santapan milat he hati, hindata kapati rani vani, नये मोल देता धनचिया राशि नाही ते आकाशी पाताळी ते तुका म्हणे मिळे जीवाचिये साठी नाही तरी गोष्टी सांगो नये सेंटलीनेस इज नॉट टू बी परचेस्ड इन शॉप्स नॉर इज इट टू बी हॅड फॉर वॉन्डरिंग नॉर इन कबर्ड्स नॉर इन डेझर्ट्स नॉर इन फॉरेस्ट्स इट इज नॉट ऑब्टेनेबल फॉर अ हीप ऑफ रिचेस It is not in the heavens above, nor in the entrails of the earth below. Tuka says, it is a life's bargain, and if you will not give your life to possess it, better be silent. Entrails, the innermost part of something.
The word kapat also means a cave, a hollow space in a mountainside.
24-10-1930 हेची दान देगा देवा तुझा विसर न व्हावा गुण गाईन आवडी हेची माझी सर्व जोडी न लगे मुक्ती आणि संपदा संत संग देई सदा तुका म्हणे गर्भवासी सुखे घालावे आम्हासी ओ गॉड ग्रँट ओनली दिस बोन आय मे नेव्हर फॉरगेट दी अँड आय शॅल प्राइज इट डिअरली I desire neither salvation, nor riches, nor prosperity. Give me always company of the good. Tuka says, on that condition, thou mayest send me to the earth again and again. Mayest, Old English for may. 28-10-1930
Exercise Question 1. Read the following extract and answer the questions given below it. Know him to be a true man till incarnation of divinity. 15-10-1930 1. Answer the following simple factual questions. 1. Whom is this extract about? Answer. The true man. 2. What is a true man's heart saturated with? Answer. Completely with gentleness. 2. Answer the following. complex factual questions. 1. Who does the true man described in this extract take to his bosom? Answer. The true man described in this extract takes to his bosom those who are in distress. 2. Who does the true man described in the extract receive as his own? Answer. He receives only the forsaken as his own. 3. How does the man described in this extract treat others? Answer. The man described in this extract treats his manservants and maidservants with the same affection that he shows to his children. 3. Answer the following. Interpretative type question. Write from the extract two sentences that indicate that the man described in this extract is close to God. Answer. 1. Know that God resides in the heart of such a one. 2. He is the very incarnation of divinity. 4. Do as directed. Grammar questions. 1. What need is there to describe him further? Rewrite as an assertive sentence. Answer. There is no need to describe him further. 2. He is the very incarnation of divinity. Add a question tag. Answer. He is the very incarnation of divinity, isn't he? 5. Answer the following. Vocabulary question. Write from the extract words that mean, first, great sorrow, pain or trouble. Answer, distress. Second, abandoned or neglected. Answer, forsaken. 6. Answer the following. Personal response type question. How do you treat those who are inferior to you? Answer, I treat them as my equals with dignity and respect. Question 2. Read the following extract and answer the questions given below it. Wherever I go, till, within and without. 22/10/1930. 1. Answer the following. Simple factual questions. 1. Who is the speaker addressing? Answer. God. 2. What has the speaker attained? Answer. Divine peace, both within and without. 2. Answer the following. Complex factual question. What does God do for the speaker? Answer. Wherever the speaker goes, God is his companion. He takes the speaker by his hand and moves him. The speaker goes alone, depending solely upon God. God bears his burdens. If the speaker is likely to say something foolish, God makes it right. God has removed his bashfulness and made him self-confident. 3. Answer the following. Interpretative type question. How does the speaker consider all the people? Answer. The speaker considers all the people as his guards, relatives, and bosom friends. 4. Do as directed. Grammar questions. 1. Having taken me by the hand, thou movest me. Rewrite using and. Answer. Thou have taken me by the hand and thou movest me. 2. Thou hast removed my bashfulness and madest me self-confident. Underline the main clauses and put a box around the conjunction. Answer. Thou hast removed my bashfulness. Thou hast made us me self-confident are the main clauses. The conjunction is and. Here the subject and the auxiliary verb are implied and hence put in the brackets. 5. Answer the following. Vocabulary question. Mahatma Gandhi has used the old forms of some words to maintain the style of the Abhangas. Identify those words and write their meanings. Answer. First, thou, you. Second, art, are. Third, movest, move. Fourth, thee, you. Fifth, bearest, bear. Sixth, makest, make. Seventh, hast, have. Eighth, madest, made. 6. Answer the following. Personal response question. Who is your inspiration and your guide when you are alone? Answer. Usually it is the words of advice of my parents that give me a lot of inspiration. But I also believe a lot in God. I have great faith in Him and trust Him. Question 3. Read the following extract and answer the questions given below it. Merit consists in doing till better be silent. 24/10/1930. 1. Answer the following. Simple factual questions. 1. What does merit consist in? Answer. In doing good to others. 2. What does sin consist in? Answer. In doing harm to others. 3. What, according to the speaker, is hell? Answer. Deliberate or purposeful lack of interest in the divinity is hell. 4. What should one exchange to possess saintliness? Answer. One's life itself. 2. Answer the following. Complex factual questions. 1. What does the speaker say regarding our relation to God? Answer. The speaker says that taking God's name on one's lips is itself salvation. Disregard of this is known to be perdition. 2. Which paths and places, according to the speaker, are useless in seeking saintliness? Answer. According to the speaker, seeking saintliness in the marketplace or by wandering or among heaps of riches or in the heaven above or in the innermost part of the earth are all useless. 3. Answer the following. Interpretative type questions. 1. What great secret about leading a good life is revealed in the first part of the extract? Answer. The first part of the extract reveals the truth in the only religion of freedom. Untruth is bondage, and there is no secret like this to lead a good life. 2. What piece of advice does Sant Tukaram give to the people in the first part of this extract? Answer. After enlightening people about the distinction between what is good and what is injurious, Sant Tukaram led the people to choose what is right or proper. 3. What piece of advice does Sant Tukaram give to the people in the second part of the extract? Answer. In the second part of the extract, Sant Tukaram says that if one cannot exchange one's own life for saintliness, then it is better that one be silent about saintliness once and for all. 4. Do as directed. Grammar questions. 1. Truth is the only religion. Rewrite as a negative sentence. Answer. There is no religion other than truth. 2. Studious indifference is hell. Add a question tag. Answer: Studious indifference is hell, isn't it? 5. Answer the following vocabulary question. Write from the passage words that mean: first, slavery. Answer: bondage. Second, a state of punishment which goes on forever. Answer: perdition. 6. Answer the following personal response type question. Given a choice between the two paths shown in the first part of the extract, which would you choose? Give reason for your answer. Answer: I would choose the path of truth because ultimately I want to attain salvation. Question 1. Read aloud the Abhangas given here in the Devanagari script. Students can do this on their own. Question 2. With the help of these translations, write the summary of each Abhanga in short, using simple words. Students may write this on their own. Question 3. These translations are available on the website www.tukaram.com. Visit the website to obtain more information on Sant Tukaram. Students can do this on the internet.